So.
Warning: the following segment depicts highly dangerous activities. We strongly advise against the performance of any similar acts by our viewers.
Steve, okay. I'm asking you not to do it.
I know, you always
Where's
do
it going?
Okay, this is my new cool trick.
You're not going to bleed, right?
I don't even care.
Think I might. It's
don't
called,
do it.
It's called my face piercing act.
Oh, no,
dude.
This kid is the best.
Oh, wait, just tell me what you're doing.
He's going to stick that through his jaw.
Oh, no, don't.
Steve, stop. You're going to hurt yourself.
Oh, my God.
Stop.
Down the show today. Well, I've got a number of things to promote. I'm now a video game hero. I've got a documentary about my life coming out next month, which I'm really proud of. And only in the cab on the way here did I figure out what stunt I was going to do to scare Howard. So it's going to have to be my face piercing act.
Steve-O is a entertainer.
That's a good way to put it.
He's at the top of his profession.
Yeah, some guy was telling me he knew him in, like, high school, and he said he was lighting himself on fire back in high school.
Right. This isn't something he just thought of.
Let him come in and say hi. I don't have much time for him because he showed up late. I had him all scheduled. Hard to believe he's not responsible.
You just have time to hit yourself in the face with a hammer.
Steve, you screwed up, man.
Let's find out about this. Where were you?
Wait, Steve.
Wait, he's giving me an apologize. He's giving me an apology. What's going on? What happened to you this morning, brother?
I just didn't want to get out of bed, dude. I'm going to level with you.
All right, that's cool.
That's all right.
Someone told me you were dating some hot model. Now this one's unbelievable. It's like
Who's
a supermodel.
Who's now? You cheating on me?
Kind of, Robin.
Who are you?
She's a supermodel. What's her name? I read in the paper.
Mae Anderson.
Yeah. Now, who's that? She's the Wonder Bra girl?
Victoria's Secret model and Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition 2003
yeah,
and 4.
Really?
Look at you. So are you like going steady with her or something?
Well, I've gotten her busted by enough paparazzi that I'd say I'm pretty much dragging her down.
It's a deal, though. Like, is she all freaked out about you or is she embarrassed to be seen with you?
I don't think she's embarrassed, but I think the cameras make her a little apprehensive.
So how'd you get her, dude? That's a major score. That's the best you've ever gotten, to be honest.
Oh, dude, come on, of course.
Yeah. Is she hot? Like does she have a brain?
She's just rad in so many ways, dude.
Like, give me the rad list. Top 10 rad reasons.
Does she
you're going
have
up.
A brain? How would Steve oh no?
Steve, do you have a brain? Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah, I happen to be very intelligent.
Right. What do you talk to her about? Is she like really, like what do you guys talk about?
We basically party.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm.
Dude, so how'd you meet this Wonder Bra chick, and like, how'd you get her? She's got to be a little bit crazy.
Yeah, well, I guess the first time we really met was at her birthday party.
How'd you get invited to that?
I don't know. I showed up at Knoxville.
Oh, Johnny Knoxville. He knows all the chicks.
Yeah, he knows.
And he's a movie star now, yeah.
Well, baby, I happen to be a movie star, too. Just because I'm not
as much
an actor.
As he is.
Just because I'm not an actor doesn't mean I'm not a movie star.
He was in a movie, yeah.
So Johnny takes you to the party.
I guess so, yeah.
And she's, like, hanging out, and you, like, charmed her?
Yeah, I think I made her laugh. I think that's probably what worked.
You get her the first night, or did you have to...
No, I'm not claiming anything, dude. What I will claim is I would rather masturbate in the vicinity of her.
All right.
Like, more
so
than...
So you're saying you didn't have intercourse with her?
That's what I'm saying.
But that's not true.
That's what I'm saying, dude.
You wouldn't lie to me, though.
You're going
to
tell that lie and stick to it.
Dude, raise your right hand. Oh!
Oh, you nut!
Stop it! Stop it! Get it out of there!
He's gonna close the safety pin.
No! 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 Oh my God!
Warning: the following segment depicts highly dangerous activities. We strongly advise against the performance of any similar acts by our viewers.
What's going on, man? How long have you been with this chick?
Well, I've been in New York for, like, the last couple of weeks, except for, like, a quick trip in and out.
Hey, I want to meet her.
Yeah, what? You usually bring your chicks. Where is she this morning?
Yeah, no, this chick ain't coming in so easy.
I know.
This finally.
You better not blow this one.
Yeah, it's important to me to handle this delicately. And with
you're
going to
marry her?
I don't know.
How old the chick?
She's never going to turn 22.
Is she 21?
She just did.
Is she 22?
I busted her.
22.
Yeah.
Wow. You living with her? What's going on, man?
Well, I mean, I've been in the same hotel for a while.
And she's over there now?
That cohabitation.
Is she in your room right now?
Yeah.
But, give me that phone
but
number.
But she is on the pull-out sofa in the living room. Okay, dude.
All right. Where'd she grow up?
She's from Denmark.
Did her parents meet you yet?
No.
Oh.
No, but she talks to her mom on the phone and...
She don't know who Steve-O is.
I know. But her mom's like, what's this I'm hearing, you know, like...
This guy lights his balls on fire, mom.
Oh, yeah.
You're telling me you're going out, you're so pretty, you go out with a guy who lights his balls on fire?
Yeah.
You dating the stapler still? Did she tell your? Did she tell her mom?
She didn't exactly give over my resume.
Does her mom even speak English?
She does. Yeah, she does.
Are you like on the phone? Hey, ma. You staple your.
So moving on, dude. I'm a video game.
No, whoa.
Oh, look at you. Oh,
see, now you're Hollywood.
No,
When you start avoiding
I've
questions.
I've always avoided things from you, Howard.
No, you haven't.
All the money stuff. I've stayed always moving.
Yeah, but you give us a good idea.
Yeah.
Dude, this is major. Look at you.
I can't believe Mr. Hollywood now. Mr. Hollywood, oh, I can't talk. I can't talk. I have an Emmy.
No. Look at my knuckles, dude.
Yeah, I'm not gonna light myself on fire anymore. I got something to live for.
Right. Yes. I don't want an auteur.
No. May won't go out with me if I have third-degree burns all over my face.
It's stunt time.
Oh no.
What are you doing? Don't do it.
Do it.
I love
Seriously.
It. And Artie, I love you for saying that.
Do it, Steve.
What is
Come
he
on.
Got?
I love Steve.
You're telling me your new boyfriend gets defecated on by elephants.
Mom,
really, what are you thinking of doing? Don't please. It's
Artie's saying do it. Suppose it blows
it.
You up, Artie.
Well, I'll get involved. And
seriously,
maybe
Steve,
I'll get
Steve, I want to know what you're trying to do.
First, I'm going to sterilize the safety pin.
Oh, no.
Please,
Steve, stop it. Steve, look at me.
He's already saying please do it.
Sterilize it.
You know, it's a bad way to start.
Steve, okay. I'm asking you not to do it.
I know, you always do.
Where's it going?
Okay, this is my new cool trick.
You're not going to bleed, right?
I don't even care.
Think I might. It's
don't
called,
do it.
It's called my face piercing act.
Dude.
This kid is the best.
Oh, wait. Just tell me what you're doing.
He's going to stick that through his jaw.
Oh, no, don't.
Steve, stop.
My
you're going to hurt yourself.
Oh, my God.
Stop. Oh. Stop.
Oh, it's out there, right?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, you nut job.
Stop it. Wow. Stop it. Get it
and
out of there.
He's going to close the safety pin.
No. Oh, my God. I will explain what's going on as soon as I recover.
He's
Stop
closing
it.
The safety pin.
Hey, Steve, take that out, man. You're nuts. You're bleeding. Dude.
He closed it. He got it done.
Oh, my God.
So
I'm going to throw up.
So it's inside and outside his mouth.
Oh.
He stuck the safety pin through his cheek and then closed the safety pin around his lips.
Are you okay?
Now he's trying to undo
Steve,
it
right?
So he can get it off.
Steve.
I should leave it in. Huh? That'd be
oh.
Great.
How do you learn to do something like that?
Learn?
I learned it in India.
Are you in tremendous pain right now?
Kind of. I'm going to take it out.
Take it out. Dude, take it out.
Do you need some help?
You see that, Gary?
Oh.
Everybody's out there cringing.
He can't even get it out.
Steve, come on.
Steve,
did you do
it?
Oh, my goodness. Ouch.
You're bleeding, dude.
No, I mean, come on.
He put a hole in
his face. How about some applause for this kid?
Thank you.
Come on.
Applause. You're bleeding. You got a big swelling welt on your face.
Of course he does.
Your whole face is blowing up.
He needs ice now.
Is it?
Yeah.
Get the hemorrhoid.
Now May's really going to dump me.
You need hemorrhoid.
This kid should get every hot piece of poontang in Hollywood.
His whole face is blowing up as I talk to him.
Yeah, that did hurt.
This kid's a true entertainer.
You
for that 30 seconds, I forgot all my problems.
Yeah, thank you.
Warning, the following segment depicts highly dangerous activities. We strongly advise against the performance of any similar acts by our viewers.
Have you ever done anything like this before?
The
needle?
The needle I did in India, and it wasn't with the safety pin. So.
Remember when the Beatles went to India? Was that like your thing? Like they learned a sitar.
Do the needle
and
bit.
TM, he learned to put a safety pin in his face.
That was our first time in with my show Wild Boys.
Yeah.
You're having trouble talking, aren't you?
When we were up in the threes, you know, like the threes, dude.
His whole face is blowing up as I talk to him.
Yeah, that did hurt.
You never did the...
I did it with a straight, really thin pin.
He's got a hole in his cheek.
He'll be fine. This kid's invincible.
You hear what he's saying? He took a very fine needle and put it in India. Yeah. So here he comes with a safety pin.
Yeah. So, and you know what I'm kind of proud of is that I didn't wake up until 7:45. I was supposed to be here at 7:15.
Yeah.
I didn't even wake up, and I was just like, whoa, dude. I saw the clock, and I was like, is it 7:45 a.m. or p.m., dude? Like, wow. I didn't even know. And then
well,
I was
you
like,
party a lot.
And then I was like, crap, I'm late. So I get in the cab, and you know, I'm just racing over here, and I'm thinking, like, I cannot show up to Howard without something to really freak me out. So I'm like, I thought of it on the way here. I was like,
this is why he's the best guest ever. Most idiots, just they come in here late, they do nothing.
Anthony, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, Howard, I got to tell you, the funniest thing is listening to you tell somebody to stop on your show.
Well, I mean,
and he's always like that to Steve, and Steve goes ahead anyway.
I'm a big fan of Steve-O, so hey, Steve, man, you make a lot of people laugh. Love your stuff.
I'm a fan, but I got to tell you, it is really disturbing watching you hurt yourself like that.
Well, hey, dude, money doesn't grow on trees. But...
I think this kid's a true entertainer. For that 30 seconds, I forgot all my problems.
Yeah, thank you.
Brian, go ahead.
Hey, Howard. Yeah. I got to know, how does Steve-O get a piece of ass like that? I mean, just tell me how you meet a girl like that.
It has not been confirmed that I got anything.
Dude, come on.
Yeah, but Howard, this girl is so fine. I mean, have you seen, you looking at the picture?
Yeah.
She is so fine, this girl. I've seen her up close and personal. How does Steve-O even, for all the guys out there that want to date a model, how do you get a girl like that?
Well, first of all, he's on TV. He's got a lot of money. And
yeah, but you gotta wonder, what does he say to
not much
a girl?
To look at,
he probably goes, hey, wanna smoke weed? Speaking of Hollywood friends, so then I'm reading that you and Sean Penn.
Lars
Ulrich of Metallica go out to dinner together.
Well, yeah, it was the craziest night ever. Like, I'm sitting there at dinner. Once again,
how do you get to that, Johnny?
Johnny Knoxville brought me with him.
All right.
So I've got Sean Penn to my left, to my right, Lars Ulrich right across, like the female lead from the Being John Malkovich movie as well,
mm-hmm.
plus the dude who the movie The Big Lebowski's written about. I mean, this is like a celebrity-packed table.
Mm. So how does Johnny get invited to all this crap?
I don't know.
He's networked himself.
He's a cool dude, is why. But
I know. I mean, like...
He has definitely networked.
I think I'm the uncoolest dude. I don't get invited to anything.
What do? You get invited.
Yeah, Judith Regan invites me to meet, you know, Arianna Huffington.
So Dave Matthews walks up to the table.
Yeah. Right? Whoa.
Dave Matthews walks up to the table to shake Sean Penn's hand. And I say, dude, Dave Matthews. I go, dude, sometimes I'm on the road with my bros, and, like, I put my iPod on shuffle, and then you pop up, and my bros get pissed, and I'm totally embarrassed, and I hit skip as fast as I can.
Oh, that's
nice. But dude, when I'm alone by myself, I'm totally into it.
Ah, that's good.
That's nice.
And he was so cool about it. He says,
because I understand. It's kind of you listening.
You don't want your pros listening to you.
And I said, but when I'm alone, I'm into it, you know? And he was so cool about it. He said, I admit I tend to be a little bit feathery and fluffy.
Yeah, he is.
And so I told him, I was like, dude, you sing to girls, and I just admitted to you that I'm listening. I mean, don't worry about it, bro.
Sometimes I hit shuffle on my iPod, and it just comes up and says, give oral to a guy.
Not in front of my bros.
But when I'm alone.
So hey, now, someone, the last time I was here.
But I heard that Lars was kind of cheap at dinner.
Well, no, it wasn't that. I mean, this was just observational on my part. But you got to figure that Lars has like $100 million.
Easily.
You know?
Yeah.
Easy. So when it came time for the check, and I mean, I know I'm going to be running my mouth right now.
Where'd you go to eat?
And I know that Sean Penn and Lars are good bros, and, you know, nothing personal. But I don't even know the name of the restaurant. And it was just me and Sean Penn and Knoxville, and then Lars came in with a bunch of people. He said, hey, let's all get a table together.
Right.
So it's kind of time to pay the check, and Sean Penn's just pulling it out, and Lars is like, no. So he insists on making the waiter, like, split the, you know.
You're kidding.
You know, it's just kind of.
You're kidding.
I'm just thinking, you're so rich, you know. And so then, Lars makes that happen.
Well, let me ask you something. So did Lars split the check like he wanted Sean Penn to pay for his stuff, him to pay for his own stuff, and what about, and you had a split too?
No. They were splitting it equally themselves.
Oh, 50-50.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so just what struck me was, like, once the check was split, and then Lara screams across the table, "Hey, Sean, what did you tip?"
Oh, really?
Oh. And I'm just thinking, like, dude.
Lame.
I even said, like, I said it at the time. I was like, dude. You know, I mean, you can't spend money when you're dead, dude. Like, what are you saving it for?
Tip that waitress $100,000.
You know, right. I mean, like, Sean Penn, what do you tip? And it's like, I don't want to say it's like asking Napster for your money back. There's five celebrities on it. It's me, Carmen Electra, Jamie Kennedy, David Arquette, and Funkmaster Flex. And,
but don't they have to have some celebrities on it?
They don't. He just screw you, pal.
Yeah, Bobo, real quick, go ahead, because I got to...
Hey, how you doing there, hey. Bobo? Steve-O, two questions for you, man, big fan. How many tetanus shots have you had so far since been doing all these wacky stunts?
Well, dude, come on, tetanus lasts for 10 years. I only needed one.
He sterilizes the needle. What, have you been listening?
Oh, man, dude, I'm three shots away from being vaccinated from rabies for life.
Rick,
I'm so
ahead.
Proud of that, dude.
Really?
So
why? Because you've been bitten by animals?
Yeah, I get bitten by animals for a living.
And is it true the rabies shots, you get them in the stomach?
Not anymore. That was back when Ozzy did it.
How many?
So you've got to take three more?
Three more, and it's permanent. I can get bitten by anything I want for the rest of my life.
All right.
He's so crazy.
You're high, aren't you?
Well, I saw a great... I'm just kidding.
Oh. All right, anyway, Steve-O's DVD, The Early Years, which is a great DVD, is going to be available in stores at the end of August. Steve-O is featured on the ESPN video game NFL 2005, available in stores at the end of July.
What does he do on that?
It's so funny.
What do you do?
It's there's five celebrities on it. It's me, Carmen Electra, Jamie Kennedy, David Arquette, and Funkmaster Flex. And
she's hot, Funkmaster Flex.
So what we do, it's like each celebrity has a dream team where, mm-hmm. like, and you have to earn money by beating the celebrity dream team. It's a video game that's rated G, but for games it's called E. It's rated for everyone.
But don't they have to have some celebrities on it?
They don't.
He just listed the Mount Rushmore of celebrities.
Yeah, hey, wow. Funkmaster Flex.
How'd they get those people?
Wow. How'd they entice them to do this?
Weren't you guys busy? Hey,
you know, for me, it's a pretty cool list to be on, okay?
I know. And the early years, that's really when you were nuts, I imagine.
Yeah, I was really worse when I was
younger. You had nothing to live for.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right.
But in any case, like, it's this G-rated video game. They brought me on to make it as filthy as possible, you know?
Do you think you're insane? Seriously.
I think that I'm far from it. Like, so, you know,
and stuck it through your cheek.
Yeah, but when you plan deliberately when you're going to be crazy,
right.
like, you lose all craziness, you
okay.
know? Like, I really thought about it on the way here. Like, what can I do that's going to seem crazy?
When you were younger, did your parents ever have you evaluated or something like that because they thought you were nuts?
You know what they did? They did everything in their power to try to get me diagnosed with ADD so they could just drug me up so I wouldn't be such a hassle.
Right.
And not one single doctor would do it. They take me to the next doctor and the next...
Were you a nightmare as a kid growing up? I mean, like,
oh, yeah,
like would you not even go to school? And would you?
Nah, I would go to school, but...
You were always in trouble.
That didn't help much.
Were you like a juvenile delinquent? Did you go to juvie hall? Did you...
No. I never got arrested until the night before I graduated high school.
All right.
But your parents had to go to school a lot and talk to the teacher,
yeah. Absolutely.
Wow.
Absolutely. You know, the last time I was here, I told you that I was genuinely concerned that it would be my last time coming in to see you.
Why?
Well, because I guess Clear Channel, they...
Oh, because we might not
and
be
they had,
here.
Yeah, because they had, you know... And
Clear Channel's trying to assume it's ridiculous.
And I want to congratulate you for being picked up in every damn market they dropped you
Thank
in.
You.
You're back to full force.
Yes.
And, you know, we're doing it.
All right. Well, anyway,
so
you're
I have
man.
This one other little quick story.
Go ahead.
So I go and do this festival in the UK, which Metallica played at.
Right.
And I did this set. It was just, I was the weirdest thing in the lineup, you know, like
right.
me and my alcoholic self-mutilation act. And at the end of my performance, I gave out 20 crates of eggs to the audience. And I had no idea who came on stage after me. But I gave out to like 20 crates of two dozen, you know, a piece. And I said, be very careful not to break any of these eggs until the next act comes on. And I didn't even know who they were. So this poor band, Electric Six, out of Detroit, they come walking out on stage, just this hailstorm of eggs. I mean, the lead singer's wearing a white blazer. He's just covered. Like, the guitarist can't even, his feet are slipping around on the stage. Like,
right.
I mean, it was so amazing. So afterwards, you know, we're in the artist area, And this guy comes up and pours beer all over me. One of the Electric Six band members.
Well, you could see he'd be mad, yeah.
Well, I mean, come on.
He got hit with eggs. Yeah.
And most of the beer wound up landing on a girl, for God's sakes.
Right.
So I told Chris Pontius, my Wild Boys co-star,
right.
I said, dude, this guy just poured beer on a girl. And he steps into a wrestling singlet, goes over to their trailer demanding to fist fight every single one of those guys. And they locked themselves into their trailer. Six guys afraid to fight one man locked themselves in their trailer. So Chris Pontius tries to punch one of them. Never, no thought for the window. Just punches right through. And then they locked us in our trailer. I peed all over it. So I want everybody listening, screw those bastards.
There you go. Steve-O's DVDs. Let's get them.
He's at war with everyone.
He needs money. He's got an expensive girlfriend now. Early Years available in stores at the end of August. And Steve-O is featured on the ESPN video game NFL 2005, available in stores at the end of July. Great guy, Steve-O.
And Howard Stern's not going anywhere.
Well, we'll see.
Not if sure. Steve-O has anything.
It's going to be a battle between
Thank
us.
Thank you, Steve, for sticking up for me.
We'll see who lasts longer, me or Howard.
What'd you call yourself, Steve?
Well, so you can't even stand in, can you?
Yeah, you got a nice little red hole in your face.
Sweet, sweet. I just hope I didn't get in trouble with my girl, May.
Now, what's going to happen when you go back to the hotel?
I'm sure. I hope she was listening, and I don't think I did anything to get in trouble.
You didn't say anything bad about her.
No. There's nothing bad to say about her. So I'm out of here, man. I gotta get back to Megan.